Good morning, everyone. It's my pleasure to speaking about brain-computer interface by means of EEG and EEG source imaging in this workshop. First of all, I would like to introduce to the general audience about what is a brain-computer interface. This cartoon illustrates a very simple but intuitive concept about you have a brain, you have a computer. The interface between brain and a computer is usually what we call the brain-computer interface. And of course, we have various signal acquisition and in order to pick up the signals. This slide illustrates a more elaborative description about the brain-computer interface. Essentially, brain-computer interface, or sometimes we call the BCI, is a bidirectional and concept. And on one hand is we have these sensors and put on either over the scalp or surface of the brain or inside the brain to record the signals and perform signal processing and feature extraction, feature translation to decode our intention and then to control an external computer or external world. And for example, you can replace motor function, restore lost function, and enhance motor function, and so on. On the other hand, there's another route is not just brain decoding, but actually encoding information inside the brain. That's, on the other hand, sometimes also is being called a neuromodulation. That is, we inject physical energy to intervene with the central information processing. But in my presentation today, I'm going to focus on the brain control and aspect of the brain-computer interface. Now, as what we talk about, there's multiple ways to acquire signal and to decode brain signals. And my talk today is focusing on BCI or brain-computer interface using EEG. Now, here is a illustration to show what the EEG is recording and picking up. Once you have a neuronal excitation, you're generating a neural current inside and flowing through passive volume conductor and to show up either EEG or MEG over the scalp, which reflecting synchronized the neuronal activation. Therefore, if we have a thought, if we have a certain process occurring inside our brain, it will be reflected in EEG. If we record that, if we do certain machine learning signal processing, we would be able to decode the intention. Now, one particular technique actually we use in some of our recent work is something so-called EEG source imaging. That is, you record EEG with aid of anatomical MRI, we perform source imaging to get accurate high resolution and the brain excitation information inside the brain from entirely non-invasive scalp EEG. Now let's come back to really the societal need for BCI or brain-computer interface. In the United States alone, we have more than 5 million people who are paralyzed. And to take one of the major causes, that is spinal cord injury, that cost our nation more than $40 billion per year. And also, if we look at an individual and a patient, if for age 25, a spinal cord injury patient is going to cost almost close to $5 million throughout the life. So this is really huge public health and burden to our society. Now, what kind of clinical application BCI could do? And here, this chart is the illustration. This is about the stroke. About 30% of the paralyzed patient is caused by stroke. 30%, another 30% is due to spinal cord injury. So for these patients, and certainly there are some others, you need to do the rehabilitation to gain independence and to have communication skill. And a BCI can help physical therapy and could help neural robotics. That is, you could have a thought control or mind control robotic device, and it could help with and communication. That these are just a few examples of the brain-computer interface. Now get to more scientific and what kind of BCI system out there. There essentially is we could simply classify them as invasive BCI versus non-invasive BCI, depending on how the signal is being recorded. So here is showing the multiple and the modality. And my work and my group is mainly focusing on non-invasive BCI using EEG. Here showing that three major EEG-based BCI and technology. For example, like P300-based, SSVEP-based, and sensory motor reason-based BCI. In particular, and we are interested in pursuing the motor imagination-based sensory motor reason BCI. That is, in this case, you are thinking, imagining moving your left hand or right hand or both hand. You are not moving because for paralyzed patient, you are not able to move. But then there will be very unique biomarkers over the EEG sensor space that can be recorded, decoded, and interpreted to control a external device. That's how this BCI and system work. So let me show you one example. This is a work actually we published in close to 8 years ago. That is for the first time in the world, we demonstrate that using EEG, we were able to control the flight of a drone. Like in this case, this is the human subject wearing an EEG and a cap. And what he's doing is just imagining moving of their left, right, or both hands. And we set a forward going velocity for this drone. So this drone is keep going forward. And if he want to turn left and he imagining moving the left and the right for the right turn and both hands for lifting and nothing to bring it down. If you want to go back, you turn left to left or right to right. So this is showing that for non-invasive BCI, EEG can be extremely powerful technique to help us to achieve such kind of neurorobotic and control. In the next work, we following this drone control is we're looking into robotic arm control. In this work, and we're using EEG, and we do something called a discrete control. That is, the subject is thinking, but just by thinking, to pick up one of the Lego on their table and bring it to the shelf. So it's choosing a starting point and bring it to an ending point. Essentially, that is a kind of robotic arm control. And we have looked into about 12 human subjects, and over all these group of human subjects, it was 80% accuracy in terms of picking up the Lego and 70% accuracy, including picking up the Lego and bring it to the bookshelf. And it demonstrated success in a group of human subjects and certainly through certain and control. And we, in the recent work, we keep moving this by incorporating a EEG source imaging technology for BCI, not just from sensor space, but also doing the source imaging. This slide illustrates the study design. And one of the important development we did is we do both user learning and machine learning. So in the user learning, essentially we design human experimentation in the conventionally usual called center out or discrete trial. That is starting from the center of the screen to a certain point. The continuous pursuit is, as illustrated here, we use a random generator to allow this cursor to randomly move over the screen. And in that way, we ask a subject to control it. So with this control and with various and control experimentation, and also we do the EEG source imaging by incorporating anatomical and MRI in individual human subject, and we compare sensor-based and source-based and the BCI. Eventually, we test it in device and translation in robotic arm control. This slide just illustrates that, say, if we would do the continuous pursuit training, and that we found that the improvement in the performance in the human group of human subject compared with the group of subject if they were did the discrete control, the improvement is 500%. And now if we are going to look into the subject is that with continuous pursuit training, the improvement with the discrete trial and compare with the discrete trial and training, that was a 60% improvement. So at the end, we put this technology developed into device translation and testing and looking into how that a human subject can control a continuous robotic arm control. This video illustrates, you can see that this cursor is being controlled by a random generator. Is essentially is being moving around on the screen, and the subject in real time, just by thinking, to generate EEG, which we collected using this 128 channel EEG cap, and then we solve the EEG source imaging real time, and to control this robotic arm to follow the randomly moving cursor. So this is just to illustrate where we can accomplish now. We further look into, since this is technology and in healthy human subject for robotic arm control, we did a validation study in epilepsy patient. That is, we have invasive recording in the same patient, and then we do know the seizure onset zone where it is, and then we solve the source imaging and from preoperative EEG, and then we compare with what is the known ground truth. And our result shown that the EEG source imaging actually is able to accurately and estimate and image their underlying and the source. That is validated, of course, in this case, in the epileptic patient. The last 2 minutes, I just want to mention that there's another aspect that there's a lot of the brain-computer interface, not just machine learning, signal processing, and device development. There's a very important notion that we need to bring in neuroscience research into this problem. So here is showing that we demonstrated and several years ago that for long-term meditation yoga subject, and they generated a much improved performance compared with healthy control. In a recently completed study, we conducted a large-scale human study, and we recruited, starting with more than 100 human subjects. Eventually, we end up finishing up a complete data set in 62 human subjects. And half of these subjects went through 8 weeks, something called MBSR, meditation training course, while the rest is just waiting. And at the end, we went through a series of BCI training session, and we asked a subject to essentially do, in this case, a simple control, the cursor to their, you know, the bottom, up, left, right, and this control. And then here is the major result. You can see very interesting that meditation group, which is shown by the pink color here, compared with the light blue, that's control, there is a significantly enhanced performance in the meditation group in both the absolute performance and, most importantly, in terms of the learning. Here is showing that for the two-dimensional and for the up-down control, their difference is statistically significant. So in summary, and we have been discussing, by EEG-based BCI allow us to do non-invasive decoding of mind and controlling of robotics or device, and for both paralyzed patient and could be for general population in the future, that this could be a new assistive device. And EEG source imaging can further enhance the BCI control by restoring lost high spatial frequency and allows the robotic control of robotic arm continuous movement by subject thought. Finally, and short-term mindful meditation training improves BCI control, and which demonstrate, and once again, that in order to bring the BCI research forward, we need working on both the machine learning and device side, and also the neuroscience and the brain side. I want to take this opportunity to thank my student, postdoc, and former student, former postdoc, as well as collaborators for their contribution to the work that I'm presenting here today. And I want to really thank NIH and NSF very much for the funding support. You can see that the work I'm presenting is heavily supported by the federal government. And with that, I thank you very much for your attention. I'm looking forward to a discussion, and if there's any questions. Thank you.